So this video is all about my top 10 beach detecting tips for beginners. So let's get straight into tip number one, and that has to be your detecting kit. Now, there's lots of different metal detectors on today's market, and some work on wet sand, others don't. All detectors work on the dry sand, but it's a wet sand you've got to take care of. Interestingly enough, people think beach detecting, they associate it with flip-flops, shorts, just cruising along the beach with a metal detector, but that's not the case, is it? You know, here in the UK, some of your best beach detecting times are in the howling wind and the rain, as I experienced last week. Right, here we go, bit of wet sand now. Not a murmur at all. Single frequency machines tend to be a bit unstable on the wet sand because the wet sand is actually a signal to single frequency machines, whereas multi-frequency machines still see that signal, but they cancel it out using the algorithms. And this is why I've chosen the XP Deus 2. We've got tons of videos on the XP Deus 2, so I'm not going to dwell on that too much. Using the right tools for the job. Now, there's two real choices of digging tool. You've got your sand scoop or your long shaft spade. Now, that kind of boils down to personal preference and the terrain you're searching. If you're searching the sand, wet or dry sand, the sand scoop's going to be much better. But if you're detecting heavy shingle, perhaps sometimes a spade will be your best option. Still on the subject of the correct tools, what about tech? Well, you can use your smartphone to find out what the local timetables are, and you can also use your smartphone to log the GPS areas of the good find, such as an app like the GoTerrain from XP. And also clothing, make sure you bring the right clothing for a beach, because if you've traveled from inland, by the time you get to the beach, the temperatures can change drastically. And bring the right footwear, bring wellies, because those waves can really lap up quickly and you'll end up getting soaked in no time. One very important thing to lead you to successful finds is beachcraft, knowing the beach you're searching. Always try and take a few trips down to the beach before you detect, find out where the holiday makers are, and search around those areas, find out where they've been sitting out of the wind, for example, along beach defences or groins, and look out for those cuts and washouts. But bearing in mind, these washouts change drastically from day to day. It all depends on wind condition and tides.
A huge piece of rock. Look at that compared to my dais. Look, you've got a wide open beach and that thing just stuck in the middle of it, look.
So Bob's just been giving me a little bit of information here. He's saying, well, it makes sense actually. You see where it's washed out around here and washed out around here and washed out third one down? That's going to give us the best chance of finding something, because this is all what they call the washout. We've got a line of weed there, and the weeds, according to Bob, would bring in all the old fishing tackle. So you're going to find a lot of weights and hooks and things like that there. But can you see now these washouts? We've got three or four washouts on this new bay, which I want to try. Here is a nice firm cut. Can you see how the ground's cut away? So I've been rightly informed if we're going to find anything, there's a good chance it's going to be in these sort of areas. Well, I've just noticed something. I'm working along this groin here, and I've gone to the other side of it. Look at the difference in height there is between this piece of sand, gravel, and that piece of gravel. So obviously that's the lower side of the beach. So I think what I'm gonna do is hop over onto this side of the beach, because obviously more sand's been taken out there.
So once you get a feel for your said beach, you get to understand it. So if you do see anything different, such as exposed boulders or exposed shingle on a sandy beach or vice versa, that's always a good area to start searching.
I'm using the Techno program on my XP Deus, and I'll be showing you my beach settings a bit later in the video.
The reason I like to use a target ID is because it gives me a good idea of the conductivity of a target. And also, bear in mind, these targets deteriorate a lot quicker in sandy, salty conditions. So what would give you a target ID inland may be totally different to the beach. For example, clad coins corrode very quickly, so they will give you almost an iron tone. So you've got to be really careful listening out for those. And also foil. Now, foil can give the same tone as small gold, so you can't really ignore foil when detecting on a beach. So the only thing you really want to ignore is the 100% iron targets, unless, of course, you're looking for iron. For my liking, there's too much iron with that signal, but I've got to accept that I'm in a different environment today. Would you dig that target if you're inland? No. And there you go, look, that just proves a point. A clad coin of some sort. Absolutely destroyed. Tip number five is getting about on the beach. Beaches can be vast places. And your time is limited depending on the tide, so getting about to find those hot spots quickly is essential. And this is where an e-bike or an e-scooter is the perfect tool for the job. Tip number six has got to be safety. Now, you can't always detect on a sunny day. Sometimes you need to detect at night. So always tell someone where you're going, always take your mobile phone with you, and always watch out for that tide. Don't get cut off by the incoming tide or you will be in trouble. So it's always a good idea just to use a bit of common sense, guys, because that sea out there, as they say, is a cruel mistress. This one, in this instance, isn't small. It's, look at that, part of a cannon. I wonder how old that is. Tiny little cannon. Tip number seven is a really important one. Try and tap into the locals' knowledge because they can fast track you to searching the best parts of the beach. I know that having local information and guidance from expert beach detectorists has really fast tracked me to being a better beach detectorist. So don't be frightened to talk to people. If you see someone detecting on the beach, perhaps have a chat with them, or some old boy walking his dog. Just try and get the local information because that will fast forward you tenfold. And Wayne was saying the original road used to be right down there by that wet area. That was the original road, just where Bob's digging. So that's how much the beach has changed since, well, the early 70s, I guess. Correction, not the early 70s. I was just talking to Wayne and he said this beach is eroded from that point to that point in 10 years. He said there used to be beach huts all the way down here. So Wayne's there, Bob's there, someone's walking. This, 10 years ago, up until just past where Bob was a car park. All flat, all the same height as that. And then it dropped down, and then there was beach huts all along the wet area. And then the coast went out. It never came in as far as those beach huts. But now the tide comes in over the top of this, as you can see, where it's all eroded down. So in the grand scale of things, we're in trouble. So 120 millimeters, I think that says. Right next to each other on the beach. Crikey. Tip number eight is be the grey man or grey woman or somewhere in between. I'm just saying, tip number eight is be the grey man. Don't stick out from the crowd, blend in. And by that I mean, don't go detecting around people sunbathing, wait till they've gone. And sometimes that means going out at night if the tides allow. Don't leave open holes because then you're putting your head above the parapet really, and you're gonna get the detectorist a bad name. So even though you are on the beach and the tide's coming in, fill in your holes, because someone may be running down the beach with their dog goes in a hole, and then they've got thousands of pounds worth of vet bills, and you're just gonna get a bad reputation. So always be the grey man, be polite if people come and talk to you, but just don't stand out and make a nuisance of yourself. And I think that is a really good tip.
There are some guys detecting down the end there. They started off here because we can see all the holes they've left open with the junk on top of the holes. So that's not very professional, guys, is it?
And if you find any fishing tackle on the beach, always pick it up, take it home with you, because some of these rusty hooks can be really dangerous. Sand is an abrasive element, so whatever it comes in contact with, it absolutely destroys, especially those detector shafts when you fold them down. So before you fold your detector shaft off, clean all your kit off with fresh water, and that'll give it a much better chance of surviving. And if you're wondering what stem I'm using, this is a carbon fiber stem from Italy. The company is called Metal Extreme. If you want to find out a little bit more about it, go onto the Skill School website, where I've got a review on this stem. And tip number 10 is the Beach Techno program for the XP Dayers 2. I know a lot of you have been asking for this because you love the techno program inland, but on the beach it needs a few tweaks. So let's have a look at what tweaks it needs. So the first problem we're going to encounter with using this inland techno program is the wet sand, because the wet sand gives off the signal. It comes up at about 23. So the first thing we need to do is eliminate that number 23. There's a bit of wet sand there. As I pump it to the ground, it's coming up at about 23. Though to put notch on is really easy. Menu, discrimination, expert, then we're into notch is off. So what we do is hit expert and turn it up using a plus button to 23. Let's go one more, let's go 24. Okay, so now we need tone break number 2. So we press that middle button and then we press the plus button up. And as you can see, that's nibbling away. Let's start off at about 21. So we've got a really tiny sliver of notch there. Let's go back to the detect screen and see what that sounds like. Little bit on the 25, but that's it. Now we can search without any problem at all. Now if you did want to go a little bit higher, say to 25 26, be my guest, it makes really no difference at all, as long as you don't go too high and eliminate that small gold. Now those of you who are quite savvy with the XP Dayers 2 will probably realize and say, hey, you're using discrimination at 42, so why would you want to notch out 20 to 23? Surely it's covered within the discrimination range. Sadly not, and I don't know why, I just know it is. So bear that in mind when you're setting up your beach program. If you're using the Techno program, the discrimination at 42 will not eliminate small gold. And as you've seen there, it won't eliminate the wet sand. The second adjustment I'm going to make is to the reactivity. Reactivity is 3. On this particular beach, I'm going to go down to reactivity 2 because I find it's quite stable. 1.5 is a little unstable, so 2 is a good setting. Audio response 4, leave that. Disc 42, leave that. And that's pretty much it. That is the standard techno program adapted for the beach, so you can save it to whatever you want it to be. This beach detecting is not for the unfit. Every hole you dig with this Dayers 2 is equivalent to putting a fence post in. And a bonus top tip is always make sure you've got permission to detect on the beach, because they're not all free. Well, that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. As I said, this is only a beginner's guide. We can cover the subject in more detail in the very near future. So if this has been entertaining or emotional, why not give us a thumbs up and indeed subscribe? So We can waste each other's time on a future video. Bye for now.